Hey, this is the Swedish Guitar Nerd, and I did a video about the Fly Rig 5 from Tech 21. That's the version 2. But what would I want in the Fly Rig 5 version 3? Let's find out now. Let's start with aesthetics. You have all these colored lights for showing what pedals and what effects you have engaged. And it's so close to being a rainbow. Wow, it could have been. You have like 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, it could have been a rainbow. Why not? You have so many colors. Well, that's a simple suggestion. Maybe stupid, I don't know. I would love it. Another big feature, which I suppose won't happen, but that would be a good thing, is if you can have it in as it is now when you turn each part on and off, and if you can switch to a preset mode. And why? Because the blonde sounds part, as I said in my video, interacts with a plexi part. So if you turn something up here, you turn something up here, it dramatically makes a difference to the sound. So you can't, I mean, you can of course have this as a your like clean amp, or and then you add the distortion, like if you add a distortion pedal. But since they are so interactive with each other, the way I use it, I have both on because I need both to get the sound I want. And then it would be great to have that saved as a preset, and then you can toggle between them and maybe adjust it differently and have that as a separate preset. Because now you can only turn them on and off. And of course have whatever effects you want to have on and off be on and off with just one step of a button. That would be awesome. Another thing, the pedal in itself, it's not that noisy. You can hear now it's with everything on. There's blasting boosts and, I mean, input boosts, a distortion amp. You hear there's a bit of noise, not that much, but still. In a noisy room with bad electronics, it would be a lot noisier, of course. So I would like some kind of noise gate, not because of the pedal itself, it's not that noisy, but because everything around it, what you put into it, it will probably be noisy. So it could just be like a three-way switch where you have like have it off and then just a tiny bit and then a lot. Simple as that. It wouldn't have to be anything more dramatic than that. Then you have the loop. That is a serious loop. It would be nice if I could switch between serious and parallel, so I could have, because now all the sound from this part goes out into the loop and then goes through whatever you're having and then back. It would be nice to have it as a parallel loop where you have signals going straight from this part to this part and have the loop as well. Or at least have it as a switchable option. Speaking of the loop, it would be nice, but since this is a 5-button thing, I don't know if that's possible. Maybe if you have double functionality on 2, maybe add on a third one where you can turn the loop on and off with a button. Because if you have several pedals or several effects in the loop, well, switching them on and off would be time-consuming, but if you can only just turn the loop on and off with a button, that would be great. Yeah, that's just one of the things I thought about for the version 3. I don't know if any of these are possible at all. And I'm not saying that they are essential, but if there's gonna be an update, why not? The pedal in itself, as it is now, is great. It really fulfills all my needs, and it's extremely usable. You can get so many sounds of just one pedal, and it's so, yeah, easy to bring along. It's a brilliant design, it really is. Well, just a few suggestions. I hope Tech 21 finds them useful. Maybe you found it interesting too. Okay, see you soon. Bye bye.